Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this Master Controller tutorial, I'll show you how to create a grid wizard for cell shading your character. We'll generate a grid wizard that determines the direction and position of the cell shade for a super easy and fast way to add dynamic shading to your characters. So let's start. You'll need to design a character head. I have my character, Sebastian. Choose the Rectangle tool. In the tool properties, select Autofill. I've already made a low value tone for the cell shade color. Make a rectangle shape where you want the cell shading to be positioned. Remove the line art, we don't want any outlines. Soften the rectangle using the contour editor. Make a kidney shape or a shape that best suits your design. Invert cut it with the head using a cutter. Add a peg and rotation point. Remember to fill empty cells for the duration of the animation. Add a deformer to the shape. You can add that manually or use the method animation envelope creator create envelope. Once the cell shade is rigged, create your keyframes. Aim for 9, we'll be using a 3x3 grid. You don't need to set motion keyframes, as the grid wizard automatically interpolates between keyframes. You can enable stop motion keyframe for this. Right-click on either the tool panels or the timeline and select Master Controller to add it to the interface. Or you can also go to Windows Toolbars Master Controllers. Select all 9 keyframes on the timeline and then select the Grid Wizard here. The Master Controller Grid Wizard dialog box opens up. On Load Preset, click the arrow and select a preset. Let's choose 3x3 as we made 9 keyframes. Hit OK. Move the Master Controller window so you can see the keyframes on the timeline. Select the first keyframe and the position on the grid. It will name the keyframe automatically by the frame number. Hit OK. Repeat this for all the other 8 keyframes. I'm working in an anti-clockwise direction, finishing in the center. Name it Shade. You can filter attributes and hit Create. Select the correct composite for the Master Controller to attach to. It will save the Master Controller in the Script folder of the Project folder. Once the Grid Wizard is generated, close the dialog box. Add a peg, Command P, to the Master Controller and add a backdrop. Move the Grid Wizard to the position you want using the Translate tool. You can open up the Master Controller Properties or the Layer Properties panel and customize the Grid Wizard widget. Before testing the Grid Wizard, move the timeline cursor to a frame that does not contain any of the key poses you used, so you don't override one of your poses. You might like to try putting the Grid Wizard over the character's head. Uncheck Show Limits and move the widget to see the corresponding positions of the cell shading. Or keep it to the side with Show Limits and Grid Lines checked. It's your preference. We've added an envelope deformer so we can adjust the shape if there are interpolated frames that need tweaking. And that's it for creating a grid wizard for a quick and easy way to add cell shading to characters. Thanks for watching. See you next time.